when you get fired, you kind of have this realization, like, what do you want to do? What's the next chapter of my life? There are certain brands, American-based footwear and apparel brands, that were thriving in Europe. And it made me realize that we could actually bring a fabric to that, to allow a lot of these industries to use an American-made fabric for their American-made apparel and footwear lines. I'm an investment banker, so I know nothing about fashion. My wife and I sold everything we own, sold the house, sold everything, moved to America and bought a mill.
Pretty ballsy.
Pretty ballsy. There at one time was over 300 mills in America. And in terms of the wool industry, we're down to 4. At American Woolen, we're trying to be the green shoot for textile manufacturing to take root and to thrive. Right now in America, people keep wondering, can we get craftsmen to come into the field? And I think that's probably the biggest hurdle to the future growth in this industry, is to get craftsmen to look at this as a viable occupation. It's really about trying to rebrand manufacturing. And a lot of it goes back to the pride in the craft. It makes no use if I'm making the most wonderful fabric in Connecticut and you can't cut and sew a garment in the United States. And that's something that Southwick is really trying to do.
There's very few people left making tailored clothing in the United States. You know, whether it's Jacob and American Woolen or other partners that we have locally, we've always had an interest in buying fabric from the U.S. How do you make an artisanal business in this environment? So the key is taking that heritage and building on it. It's not big investment, it's more about creativity and drive.
We got 65 people working here. These guys have a craft, they have a skill. The ability to bring that skill to an art form is something I guess I just never witnessed in banking. But I see it here. You can buy the machines, you can buy the building, I'll sell it to you. You can't buy the people.
It's an intrinsic value that they have. It's finding that we're a team. We succeed together, we fail together. I think that's the type of environment we try to build here.
I'm talking about bringing back the craft. And more importantly, really creating this made in America luxury apparel and footwear business. We're really trying to facilitate a made in America product from A to Z. It's the Allen Edmonds shoes. It's the American Woolen fabric in your sport coat. We're all about the ability to bring it all back in America.